So hi all, very good morning and good evening. So let me take an interview, okay? Yeah. So how many in Azure, how many models are there?
Three models.
Three
models. Can you name?
AIS, PaaS, SaaS, SaaS.
Okay. What is SaaS?
It's a software as service, like
for example, can you tell some of the applications which are hosted in SaaS? Okay, can you
Facebook?
You can type. Tell, like, you know, so Teams. Skype for Business, Office 365. These are all Microsoft products only hosted on the SaaS model. Okay? Yeah. So what is the main difference between so IaaS model and PaaS model? You have a lot of differences, but I want to know just what is the main difference? IaaS?
PaaS model, no Windows.
Okay.
So main one. And cost differences.
PaaS model, you don't have Windows. IaaS model, you have the Windows. That is a major difference.
And cost differences also.
Yeah, obviously cost differences. Yeah. So you have a lot of things like some.
And here we don't have a storage like whatever in PaaS model.
So when you say like no Windows means it includes everything. Okay. Like in the answer itself, it includes everything. Yeah. So in PaaS model, again, when it comes to the SQL Server, okay, in PaaS model, again, we have three models. What are all those?
Single database.
Azure
SQL DB.
Okay.
Managed instance.
And
yeah. So PaaS model, you have three types. Okay, PaaS model, you have three types: single database model, elastic pool model, and managed instance. Okay, in PaaS itself, you have three models. IaaS, one more IaaS model. Okay, total four. But in real time, now single database model and elastic pool model, we can call one type of database only.
Azure SQL DB.
Yeah, Azure SQL DB. Yeah, so yes. So even in the articles and all, right, they will mention clearly. If it is managed instance, they will say, they need to say managed instance. If it is IaaS, then they have to mention IaaS. Okay. Yes. Azure means it's not only one DB. Okay. You have three types of DBs. Yeah. So in PaaS model, three types. Yes. Okay. What is the difference between single database model and managed instance? Sorry. Single database model and elastic pool. What is the primary difference?
Hard disk is the differences.
Okay. So can you tell me in professional way? Like,
it's just so static.
In PaaS itself, no hard disk, right?
Static, so maybe elastic pool. That only one CPU design, then it will shareable for all the database.
Yeah. If we can say professionally, single database model, each database having its own resources.
Yes.
When it comes to the elastic databases, it maintains shared resources. Okay. When you go for shared resources, if it is any unpredictable database usages, then that time you can save money. Okay. Unpredictable usages of the databases, it is good to go for elastic databases rather single database model. Okay. Yeah. So per server, how many databases we can create, guys? Per server.
100.
100. Any guesses?
Including master, 150.
No. So you can create 5,000 databases, guys. One server, you can create up to 5,000 databases. Okay. We never create that many in real time. Yeah. Okay, fine. So one question, like suppose, okay, so I have a subscription, one subscription having two servers, two databases. Okay, that is one scenario. I have one subscription. It's within one subscription, I have two servers and two databases. Okay. Same, I have two subscriptions. In another scenario, I have two subscriptions. In one subscription, I have one server. In another subscription, I have another server. Okay. So what is the, is there any cost difference? Hello? So if you don't understand, let me tell you. Okay, this is a subscription. Okay, I have two servers. Guys, I have two servers like this. I have another subscription. Okay, I have another subscription. Sorry, another two subscriptions I have, sorry. Okay, I have another two subscriptions, something like this. And I have two servers like this. Okay. If I compare between these two, okay, is there any cost difference between these two? This one subscription is another subscription. If I compare sizes and all same, database sizes and all, whatever the data server in the database, I mean server, whatever the database is in the server, the same. Okay, this is like this one, this is like this one. Okay, same. Is there any cost difference?
Yes, because, sir, of course.
How cost difference?
Because there are two subscriptions, but here only one, right? Might be that is the reason.
So you are saying cost difference. So. Any other answers?
There is no cost difference because both two servers and two subscription, and one subscription and two server is, there is no differences. I think so.
Yeah. So there is no difference, guys. Okay. Suppose. Okay. These two are two dresses, okay? Just suppose, this is something 500 cost, okay? This is 300 cost. One credit card, guys. One credit card, 500 rupees, 300 rupees. Same, here two credit cards, this 500 rupees and 300 rupees. What is the difference, guys? Okay? Yeah. Always, in Azure, you have to pay based on usage. Okay, it's not you are having the five credit cards, two credit cards, one credit card. There is no difference. Okay, until unless you use. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, there is no difference, guys. Okay, but normally in real time, people will take the two subscriptions. Why they take the two subscriptions?
One is production, one is testing and development.
Yeah. One for production purpose and another for non-production purpose. Okay. So that you will come to know the difference. Okay. Cost differences, how they are putting the cost for product, how they are putting the cost for non-product. You know, they have clear picture and all. So, yeah, non-production always least priority for them, right? Yeah. They won't get any money and all for the non-production. Yes. Okay. So, how many servers we can create per subscription, guys? Okay. I think 15, guys. I don't know right now. I mean, it used to update every time. So, 15, 15 servers you can create per subscription. Okay. And each server 5,000. Okay, there are some numbers, you know, that's okay. Those are not important. Just awareness I am telling. Okay. Suppose for Azure SQL DB, okay, the database already reached to the maximum size. What will happen?
It can increase DTU.
No, it already, yeah. So what you will do after that, that's not the question, okay? So it reached to maximum size, okay? It's already reached to maximum size. What will happen to the application under, to the database under?
It, like application stop working.
Only we can read, but it's not possible to insert.
So overloading, like
what will happen?
Faster moving, like.
Okay.
We can read. We can read only database, and we cannot possible to do any update and delete and insert.
Okay.
So we can do, but it will take time actually.
Actually, once the database is reached to maximum size, okay, you cannot insert, update, delete. Okay, it requires some space. Okay, but still you can read the data. Still you can run the select queries. That is the benefit when you are in Azure SQL database.
One doubt. In on-premises, the database goes on a read-only mode, right?
No. It will go to suspect mode. Sometimes even not work.
Okay.
The database will go to the... People can't connect to the database even. So that's the benefit. Azure SQL DB. Okay. So what is the firewall rule related to Azure SQL Server? What is the firewall rule?
Can do like inbound outbound rules to connecting like users or a subscription.
Can you tell me in simple way?
We can restrict the users, like we can create the rules.
By default, already restricted. So if I want to connect, just we need to add the IP addresses so that we can allow them. Yeah. So we are adding server level or database level?
Database.
I think server level.
Yeah, every day, right? So one time I am One time I am adding the IP. After connecting to the server, I am again creating database, right? Still, I am able to connect to other databases. That means I just added server level. You cannot add database level in the portal.
Okay.
But still, you can add. Database level by running the queries. Okay, there is one SP underscore something. Okay, add firewall rule DB level, add DB firewall something. There is SP. Okay, even database level also you can add. Not from the portal, through SP. Okay, yes. So yeah, this is a one of the interview question. All are interview questions only.
But Raj, we can restrict the users like for the specific database.
Yes.
Like.
If you want to restrict, just don't create the user. That's it.
No.
Why you need to do firewall rule? Okay.
No, I mean to say like user need to only read only access. So we can
We have roles, right? DB reader role. We have, you can give DB reader role. Our only specific tables, give object level, grant selector, so-and-so table to so-and-so user. Okay. So, we have three kind of roles, right? Server level role, DB level role, object level roles. Server level, we don't have. Only DB level and object level.
Yeah, one more thing, Raj. Same question you asked us. Like, if it is reaches a database size, so in that case, we want to scale, like increase size. In that case, we need to take downtime and we need to press.
Actually, scaling up, scaling down. Actually, so Microsoft is saying it won't take any downtime and all. Okay, but I don't know how they are saying downtime and all. See, what will happen when you scale up is. So suppose scale up activity, it takes 10 minutes, suppose, okay? Not, it won't take more than 10 minutes even. So suppose it takes 10 minutes. 10 minutes completely, it won't be downtime. Still, DDL, DML, all the commands will work. But a fraction of time, it disconnects and it connects again. Because it has to detach and attach, okay? Because when you scale up and scale down, okay, maybe sometimes suppose you are standard to premium if you are going. They need to keep the MDF, LDF files to the high performance disks, right? They need to keep. So always when you are scaling up, when you are running a query, suppose any insert query, so it will cancel that query. Okay, so you see a downtime, but not that much, you know, scale up. If it is taking 10 minutes, means 10 minutes people won't connect. It's not like that. People still can able to connect, but a fraction of a second it goes down and connect again immediately. But application side, that's fine. So if anything is failed, then they have a option of retry option and all. But when you running some commands through Management Studio and all, so those commands obviously stop. Okay, because those commands will be killed, right?
Yes. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm seeing with a different name you joined today. You joined from mobile?
No, Raj. From my laptop.
P. Hilari something I'm seeing. Your name is?
No, my name is Satish.
Raj, it's Prasad. Prasad. Prasad.
Ah, Prasad. Okay.
Yeah, it taken my laptop name. So.
Okay.
User ID.
Okay, Prasad. No problem.
Yeah.
Okay, so if I want to refresh a database, one subscription database, I want to refresh the another subscription. Okay, is it possible? Yes or no? Or if it is possible, then how?
Sorry, can you repeat again?
I have one subscription here. Okay, one subscription to another subscription, I need to restore the database. One server to another server. But not in same subscription.
So it's depend on which model you are doing.
Same model, Azure SQL. Okay.
Use copy command.
Yeah, create database as a copy you can use. Okay, even different subscription also it will work, guys.
Yes.
Actually, in one subscription you can create many servers, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah.
So even one subscription to another subscription also you can same process, but only thing is you need to have a access to the both the servers, then only it will allow. Otherwise you cannot restore, right? How it will connect to the production and it will copy? It won't, as long as you don't have access. Okay, whatever you connected, the same login should have in production as well as non-production as well. Okay, so that is the prerequisites for restoring. Okay. So which model is the best model, guys? DTU model or vCore model?
Depends.
vCore model is best.
Depends upon the database.
Okay. Depend on the situation scenario. Okay. Can you tell me those scenarios? Suppose when you say DTU model is best.
Yeah. Before the database size below the 1 TB, we'll go with the DTU. It's a good option.
Okay. Here there is no just 1 TB. There is nowhere written actually. So it's my experience I am saying. Okay. It's my experience I am saying. Small databases you can use. You can tell. Okay. Small size databases, yeah, DTU model is the best. For large databases, yes, vCore model is the best. Why?
The cost differences, compared to both.
So how it cost, yeah. So, yeah, the same question I'm asking.
Here it will take $6,000-$7,000 in a DTU model. If it is increased the scale, so vCore model is very less. So compared to both the storage and
so why it is less?
Because in DTU, if its size of RAM and it's still low and compared to vCore.
Yeah. So here you can say easily you can say here. Okay. DTU is nothing but CPU plus memory plus IO. If you are increasing DTU means you are also buying together all these things. But in vCore model, you don't need to buy together. Whatever if you need, just you can expand. That way you can save the money. Okay. You don't need to increase all the things in V4 model. Whatever you need, that you can increase. Okay. Applications are different applications, right? So some applications, they need more memory. Some applications, they need only space, not much memory and CPU. So in that cases, V-Core model is the best. But DTU model is a, so it's a mixed kind of, whether you, even when you don't need also, you need to take it, just 1+1 offer kind of, okay? Another thing is DTU model, which starts with at least five DTUs minimum. But V-Core model, it starts with 2 CPUs minimum. 2 CPUs is nothing but almost 200 DTUs, okay? For small databases, I don't need 200 DTUs. That means 2 CPUs, not required. Just 5 DTUs are enough, 10 DTUs are enough, 20 DTUs are enough, something. So that's why for small databases, DTU is the best. And for large databases, yeah, V-Core model is the best. Why large databases, V-Core model is the best? Because large models, large databases, always they have different requirements. Like large databases, they just want only the spaces. Some they just need the only CPU, and some they just need the only memory. So that can, so large databases always this kind of requirements. Yeah. Okay. So almost for every question you are answering, guys, I'm really happy for this batch. So suppose, okay, on-premise database, I want to migrate into the, IaaS model, okay? Suppose a 20 terabyte database, I want to migrate into the IaaS model. So what is the best way?
Create storage and make it a full backup and restore there into as a read-only and take it again, log backup and restore there.
Okay. So, with no recovery mode, not read only mode. That is what any other alternative backup and restore other than?
Can we add into always on, like as the secondary?
Always on, again, it cost more, right?
Log shipping
is the best
data
because 20 terabytes, right? 20 terabytes. After full backup, taking log backup or differential backup, it again, you know, takes time. Copying takes time. You need to stop the application, you know, while taking the transaction log backup or differential backup. You don't need to take the transaction log backup, guys. Just take the differential backup, okay? Differential backup includes everything, okay? Yeah. So for large, very large databases, yeah, it's good. Log shipping is the best option. Okay, because you don't need to manually copy the backup center. It automatically taken care, right? Taking the backup, copying the backup, and restoring. Okay, you can set it up log shipping, and whenever you know downtime came, I mean, suppose today, suppose okay, suppose today Friday, you want to plan to on Saturday. Okay, Friday you can set it up the log shipping, and continuously log shipping, log backups will be restored. And as soon as, I mean, you enter into the Saturday, that time you can stop the application and just run the last log backup and copy the log backup and restore the last log backup and you can connect the application. It is very simple, right?
Yeah, Raj, but can we use the tools like a DMS service, like database migration?
When you use DMS, these are all, you know, that will take very long time. Okay, if you use DMS for this 20 terabytes, it will take at least 3-4 days. This object level, right? Table by table, data has to transfer. But backup is a kind of MDF, LDF file. You take the backup and it will restore over there. Just MDF, LDF. Okay.
For 2 TB, how much it will take approximately, Raj? In DTS. In migration service, how much time it will take around?
When you go with the data migration service, when it takes even, okay, 2 days, 3 days also doesn't matter as long as you have a online migration.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Okay, it doesn't matter. Okay, only incremental, whenever you are doing transferring the incremental changes, right?
Yeah.
That time only you need a down time. Okay.
Yeah, cut over like this, like
cut over time. Yeah. Okay. So for IAS, for managed instance, you can still go with object level also using transaction replication, using DMS, using migration as state tool also. But the thing is, it's unnecessary burden and unnecessary time waste. Okay, you can go directly with backup and restore. Depend on the type, always you need to choose a different way, different model.
Yeah, backup in the sense that we can store it in blob storage. From there, we can, using URL only, we can do like this.
Yes, obviously. Yeah, for managed instance, so you need to keep in URL. Okay. URL also, backup is same. Okay, just instead of disk, you are keeping into the blob storage. And from there, you can restore directly.
Okay.
But what are the limitations, guys, in the backup? In the, I mean, database, you should not have the multiple log files. Okay. These are some, if you have multiple log files, you cannot restore in managed instance. Okay. You cannot restore. IAS is nothing but on-premise. For SQL DBAs, for SQL DBA guys, IAS is nothing but on-premise. Okay. Same roles and responsibilities will be carried over. Let's see. Next question. What is reservation, guys? Reservations in SQL Server. Reservation. Yeah. Suppose whenever you are using any databases, so and so. Suppose if you use the database 1 year, you can get the disk, but you need to register first. Okay. So reservation for 1 year and 3 years we have.
Okay. Is it like renting the cloud to put your database in?
No. You are just if you use long, then they will give some discount.
Okay.
Okay. If you use long, they are giving some discount. If you are using one year, they are giving some discount. If you are using 3 years, then they are giving more discount. But you need to register that one. Okay. There is called the reservations here.
So it means the same way we need to be mentioned the how much time we need to be required, like 1 year or 2 years.
No, it fixed 1 or 3 years. Either 1 or 3. We do not have 2.
Okay.
Only 1 and 3. Okay. So yeah, you can purchase the reservation. Okay. You can purchase the reservation so that they can give some discount.
Yeah, right. This reservation is part of disk space, like space.
Not disk space, database.
Yeah.
Database or virtual machine, anything.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
anything. So yeah, what is a hybrid model? Next question. What is hybrid model?
That is a combination of public and private.
We have license version, then they will give some discount.
Yes, when you surrender the license, they will give the discount. That is called hybrid model.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So yeah. You can see in these are all Azure calculator. Okay. Suppose, okay, Azure SQL database. So that option only available in Azure Hybrid Benefit. That is only in vCore model, guys. When I click on DTU model, it's not there. See? It's not there. Only vCore model hybrid benefit is available. Okay. See, pay as you go, this is the charge. When you surrender the license, then this is the charge. A huge difference, 3,000 and 1,000. And this is the reservation. See, 1 year, they are giving this much discount. For 3 years, they are giving this much discount. You can cancel reservation at any time. Okay? You can also cancel reservation at any time. When you cancel, that time onwards, the normal charges applicable. Okay? So when 1 year reservation, then this is the cost per month. Okay? You are saying almost $1,000 when you go for 1 year reservation. Okay? When you are going for 1 year reservation, you are saving 1,000. But everybody can go, right? As long as you are canceling in middle, everybody can go. But the problem is, for reservation again, you have to pay some money. Okay? Just like taking the card. Okay? For card taking, they are charged some money, like $500. So suppose reservation cost is 500 and a year, so 2,500, right? Okay. Almost. So how much you are saving, guys? 3,000. And so if you reservation cost plus whatever you are saving is more than the reservation cost, guys. Okay. You are saving more than the reservation cost.
Yeah, Raj, can we take like first time only reservation or in middle of also can we take?
In middle, at any time. Any time you can take the reservation, any time you can cancel the reservation.
Okay.
Yeah. This is also SQL license related also. Hmm? Yeah, any time. Not from the beginning. No. Okay. So what is the difference between geo replication and geo replication and availability group and geo replication in Azure SQL database model? What is the difference between geo replication and availability group?
Availability group can be in the same region, and in geo replication, like we can choose another destination.
You are saying in reverse way. So, availability group means a group of databases, right? Group of databases always it is for disaster recovery. Yes or no?
Okay.
If it is disaster recovery, it should not be same region. Right?
Mm.
Yes.
If it is disaster recovery, you should not keep in same region.
Then geo is the like
have geo is the yeah, you can keep in same region also. You can also keep a different region, but it is you can also keep same region. Because that's not mostly for disaster recovery, it is for high availability.
Geo, can you repeat again? Geo is for high ability, right?
Geo replication, that is one to one. One database to another database. Okay. Here, availability group. So the name itself, availability group means a group of databases. If you are grouping of databases, means you have the what? Listeners.
Yeah.
When listeners means that is disaster recovery, obviously you should keep the different region. That is the meaning of disaster recovery.
Okay, got it.
Okay. The name itself, you can find the answers. Okay. You don't need to remember. Just name itself, you can search for the answer. You cannot remember all things, you know. That's why just name itself, we have everything. Yeah. So, suppose in vCore model, our vCore model or DTO model, I want to keep my database in which pricing model I can keep. In D2 I have 3, in vCore 3. So which model I can keep my database? Production database.
Production database in D2 is premium.
Okay.
And so this one, vCore is the business critical.
Business critical. Okay. Business critical I can keep on vCore model. And D2 model, you can keep in premium. Why premium? Why business critical? What are the benefits?
So faster, like IOE is a very fast in.
That is one benefit. What other benefit? Yeah. So we have read scale out option. Okay. We have read scale out option. So when any select queries are run, so backend database, those queries will run. Okay. So I told you, right? So without high availability and disaster recovery, if you are in premium or business critical, for every database, okay, for every database, it will maintain the, in the backend, it will maintain the another database. Okay. If any select queries are come, okay, if any select queries are come, those select queries will not run here. It will run on here. Okay. So that you can save the detail or V course here. Okay. So yes, performance obviously the good, right? Only select queries, it will go for this database. For this one, they are not charging anything. That is the only, that is the benefit we are in. We have in premium and business. Read scale out option. People call it as a read scale out option. Okay. So that's enable. So we need to, so by default it is enable read scale out option. So, but the connections, okay. In the connection thing, you have to mention application intent equals to read only. Then only those connections will go to the backend database. Okay. So it's already there, right? PPT, PPT, PPT. Say we are in business critical here. See, enable read scale out. Okay, this option not available in other models. Only premium and business critical. Okay, read scale out. Yeah. Okay. So what else, guys? Any questions from your end? Hello? Yeah. So this is about mock interview, guys. Okay, so if you have any doubts on that, you can ping me. I'm just stopping the recording.